swine in Slovak svinja is it was inspired by recent events in Slovakia. One of my colleagues was murdered together with his fiancée in their own home for his journalistic work. But the novel shows almost 25 years of development in the country, and it ends with the murder of a journalist. So it's not about the murder, but about the country when such a horrible thing can happen. I started to write almost on accident, or by accident. I had a very good friend at a big publishing house. I entertained him with my old unpublished stories as journalist, and he talked me into writing fiction, crime fiction. It was an immediate success, but this novel, The Swine, it was almost an internal necessity to write about it. I was convinced at that time that the murder of Jan Kuciak will be never properly investigated. So I wrote a novel where I didn't have the facts. And as a journalist, you can't tell the truth to your audience. You are able only telling the facts. You have to collect the facts, verify the facts, and you are writing the facts. You can't call, you can't tell the truth. As a fiction writer, you are able to tell the truth without using a single fact. So that was what I made with the novel. I tried to show to the people how the country works, how the power in the country works. And that's why I'm still writing crime fiction. I can show the true face of the country without using facts, which we don't have at every time. Slovakia is not kind of a Western, it's kind of an Eastern. It's why it's so similar to the Western, it's the basics. I'm writing mostly about the east of Slovakia, which is a region very disconnected from the rest of the state, not only geographically but mentally. People living by their own rules and laws, and very often lawless, but it stands for all of the country. Swine is really about the whole country, and when the institutions are not working, when democracy is not working in a proper way, when the rule of law is on a very basic or almost a non-existent level, then it's a lawless country, and that was the Wild West in America in the 18th, 19th century. And Slovakia very often looks that way at the moment. I'm afraid the vision which I'm giving to the French readership is a very dark vision, but it's still quite realistic. And I think what's important for a French reader is to know that you are the net taxpayers in the European Union, and you are supporting with your money all the mafia and power abusers and enablers in Slovakia who are the beneficiaries of this money and who are stealing this money by hundreds of millions of euros.